pleasant and wonderful Sabbath, dear brothers and sisters. It brings me such joy to welcome all of you who have chosen to join us today, and we appreciate your presence in our morning service. I am beyond grateful to God for this special day for us to worship together and fellowship with our sister Adventist academies, even though we are separated by distance. For our afternoon worship, I invite everyone to join and learn with us through Zoom app later at 1 p.m. There are activities prepared for everyone to enjoy and be blessed once more by meeting new people. We will provide you with the Zoom link for the meeting. Our theme for the Sabbath Fellowship is Youth 4G, God, Glory, Greatness, and Growth. When we shifted to online classes, we learned more about the wonders of technology through human innovations. We have discovered that the necessities of life are just at the tip of our fingers. Learning, doing and submitting requirements, chatting with friends, applying for government documents, banking, and of course, online shopping. But we also have realized that technology can take away our thoughts and time for the most important thing, our love for God. As Ellen G. White says, the Holy Spirit illumines our darkness, informs our ignorance and understands and helps us in our manifold necessities. But the mind must constantly be going out after God. If coldness and worldliness are allowed to come in, we shall have no heart to pray and no courage to look up to Him, the source of strength and wisdom. Today, we will hear God's inspiring message through His servant, Jonathan Melvin Sagala. Our preacher this morning hails from the Republic of Indonesia. He is currently an assistant professor at the School of Theology of Mountain View College. His main areas of study are systematic theology and church history. He earned his Bachelor of Arts in Theology from Mountain View College, Valencia City, Bukidnon, Philippines in 2017, and holds a Master of Arts in Religion, major in Theological Historical Studies from Adventist International Institute of Advanced Studies, Silangka Vita, Philippines in 2019. May we all be blessed with his sermon entitled Running. I hope and pray that the message of this fellowship will bring into individual experiences an echo in our lives in the days ahead. May we feel God's presence throughout the program as we worship together in spirit and in truth. Once again, happy Sabbath and may God bless us all. Thank you.
Good morning and happy Sabbath to everyone. This morning, as we worship, let us look to Jesus and be reminded of His goodness and grace to us. As we begin our service, we are going to read a passage out of Colossians 1 that encourages us to see Christ for who He is, our King of Kings. Colossians chapter 1 verses 15 to 20 says, "Who is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of every creature? For by Him were all things created, that are in heaven and that are in earth, visible and invisible, whether they be thrones or dominions or principalities or powers, all things were created by Him and for Him. And He is before all things, and by Him all things consist. And He is the head of the body, the church, who is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, that in all things He might have the preeminence. For it pleased the Father that in Him should all fullness dwell. And having made peace through the blood of His cross, by Him to reconcile all things unto Himself, by Him, I say, whether they be things in earth or things in heaven." Scripture says we are to bless the Lord at all times. As His bride, we have the unique opportunity to praise His name together and make much of Him. Let's read Psalms 34, 1-3, as we are reminded and encouraged to magnify the Lord together in this place today. Psalms 34, verse 1 says, "I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth." Verse 2, "My soul shall make her boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad." Verse 3, "Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt His name together." May we enjoy God's blessings as we worship Him in spirit and in truth. God bless and have a nice day.
Sabbath time can be a revolutionary challenge to the violence of overwork, mindless accumulation, and the endless multiplication of desire, responsibilities, and accomplishments. Sabbath is a way of being in time where we remember who we are, remember what we know, and taste the gifts of spirits and eternity. Sabbath honors the necessary wisdom of dormancy, a time to remember to celebrate what is beautiful and sacred. Some Sabbath time can be like this, a sanctuary in time where we consecrate with our loved ones, our yearnings for peace, our prayers for strength, and the well-being of our children. If we are too busy to see them, hold them, or play with them, they escape our blessing and we are bereft of theirs. Sabbath time is set apart for remembering the holiness of life. Sabbath time is not just for me, or it's not just any law or an obligation or something else I need to do in order to get into heaven. Sabbath is an invitation to rest, to connect and embrace life. In reality, Sabbath is a gift, one I have been leaving unopened. May we enjoy the blessings of the Sabbath as we worship Him today.
We love Thy Sabbath, Lord, and worship at Thy will. Oh, may these our sweet be suffered and deeper faith instill. Praise for Thy wondrous love that sealed this sacred day. A sign that all
let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this opportunity where we can gather here together to worship you. Please be present in the midst of us. Though we are far away from one another, though we are worshiping online, help us so we can feel your presence in our lives. Thank you for this opportunity where we can worship together to see how good you are in our lives. Please bless our worship for today. In His name we pray. Amen.
Happy Sabbath, brothers and sisters in Christ. Aren't you happy that today is an extra day when we could serve and praise our Lord Jesus Christ? As we get on with our Sabbath expressions of praise, which will be two hymnal songs, I would like to request everybody to sing it joyfully and happily this Sabbath day. The two hymnal songs that we'll be singing is What a Friend We Have in Jesus and Praise Him, Praise Him.
Take and shield thee.
this morning is entitled Hope Channel International Incorporated, April 9, 2022. Our Bible verse is found in Psalms 31:24. Be of good courage, and he shall strengthen your heart, all ye that hope in the Lord. Sharing God's good news every day, God uses the global evangelistic media ministry of hope, channel to reach thousands of viewers with the message of hope and love that comes from him. With 68 plus hope channels around the world, broadcasting in more than 80 languages. The mission of Jesus is being fulfilled with the power of the Holy Spirit. Luke 10:2. The harvest truly is great. Through turbulent and unprecedented world events, God used Hope Channel to share uplifting messages and opportunities for connection with viewers around the world. Hope at Home, a new Hope Channel program, has become the local online church service for thousands worldwide. Each weekend, by providing inspiring messages, music, and wellness tips from professionals. You can tune in Hope TV organization or at home. The Bible study platform, Hope Study, has grown to provide free and easy to use Bible study courses on topics such as igniting your prayer life, navigating stressful situations, and learning to understand the Bible better. We are also seeing more and more inspiring testimonies of viewers whose lives have been changed. You can watch these testimonies at Hope TV Transform. We encourage you to invite your family and friends to watch Hope Channel 2. Appeal. Your support for Hope Channel provides much needed resources for this global evangelistic media ministry. The General Conference regularly receives a portion of offerings from the divisions, and it redistributes the funds to mission projects and institutions. Hope Channel is included in that list. Additional offerings for Hope Channel may be given at any time in a mark in the law. Prayer. Father, thank you for the opportunity to work with you in the saving of souls. Please bless the ministry of Adventist World Radio. We know it is only through your Spirit that this work can go forward and change lives. For the kingdom of heaven. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you. Father, thank you so much for the blessing that you have done for us. Continually bless our life, also bless this tithe and offering that will be used in your evangelism. May your Holy Spirit to be with us, in the mighty power of Jesus' name. Amen.
For our scripture reading, it will be found on the book of Jonah chapter 1 verse 9 to 10. And he said unto them, I am a Hebrew, and I fear the Lord, the God of heaven, which had made the sea and the dry land. Then were the men exceedingly afraid and said unto him, Why hast thou done this? For the men knew that he fled from the presence of the Lord, because he had told them.
Let us close our eyes and bow our heads as we talk to the Lord in the form of prayer. Our most gracious Father in heaven, our Creator, our Savior, and our Provider, we thank you and praise you for the Sabbath day that you've given to us. Lord, we praise you for giving us a chance to redeem ourselves so that we can see you again. Lord, we praise you for giving us hope by your promises. Lord, we praise you because of Jesus, who you sent in this world, who gives his life in Calvary in order to save us from our sin. Lord, we praise you for showing us the way to our misdirections in life. Lord, we praise you because you are the reason why we are still here in this world. Father, we thank you for giving us this time, which is the Sabbath, to spend these joyous moments with you and learn more about your word. We thank you for giving us this online platform of worship in order to serve you amidst this pandemic. We thank you for keeping our families safe in this time of trouble. We thank you for keeping us stable physically, mentally, spiritually, and also financially, which is everyone's struggle to go on this cycle of world. We thank you for this time that we can talk to you in prayer. Lord, please forgive us for the things that we did wrong. We know, Father God, that you're sad seeing your children doing things that can hurt you and your other children. Lord, forgive us for the times that we are selfish and not putting your will first. Lord, forgive us for the times that we choose our fulfillment in this world rather than your love to us. Forgive us for the times that we are still unaware in our surroundings, even though you've given us the right direction. Father, as we continue the divine service, may you bless our messenger, Pastor Jonathan Melvin Segala. May you please guide him as he speaks, so the words that he will utter is in accordance to your will. Lord, please bless the congregation who are here for your special day. May you give us wisdom so that we can understand the things that we will be hearing later on. As the program continues, keep us safe in your hands, Father. Mold us, Father, according to your likeness, because, Lord, you are the maker, and we know that the situations where you created it, a masterpiece is already crafted. Help us to be a light in this dark world, a candle that will shine and give hope to those who doesn't know you. Lord, you know what is good for us. We lay our life to you as we get ready for your second coming. Thank you, Lord, for giving us this time to talk to you. In all we ask, in the loving name of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
You are the one that we pray.
Good morning, everyone, and happy Sabbath. Indeed, today is a beautiful Sabbath day because finally we can meet together. Though we are far from one another, but God is still good. We can still worship together this Sabbath. Before we go further, I would like to greet you. Greetings from Mountain View College. The college where I work and the college where has trained me to become who I am today. Have you heard about Mountain View College? Have you been to Mountain View College? If you have not, we'd like to welcome you. If you want to come, please contact us because we would like to have you in Mountain View College. Before we go further again, I would like to greet you in my language. It is Salamat Sabbath. In English, it is Happy Sabbath. I want to say thank you to Sir Gerard Mendoza for inviting me to be part of your program this Sabbath. Thank you, sir, for inviting me. This Sabbath, we'll be studying together from the book of Jonah. From one story, the story that tells us that we need to be faithful. We need to stay faithful. The story that showed to us about what will happen when we are unfaithful. The story that will remind us that it is dangerous when we run away from God's presence. The story that will tell each one of us that we need to stay faithful no matter what happens in our lives. Friends, I have some questions to all of you who are watching this online or to those who are joining in the Zoom this Sabbath. Are you running away from God right now? Dear sir and ma'am, dear students, dear church members, are you running away from God right now? What are your best reasons to do so? And have you discovered the risks of running away from God? Have you discovered the risks of running away from God? If you have Bible with you, can you open to the book of Jonah chapter 1? You can open it. If you have Bible with you, physical Bible, you can open it. Or probably you have your gadget, can you open it to the book of Jonah chapter 1. Let us start with Jonah 1, verse 1. Now the word of the Lord came unto Jonah, the son of Amittai, saying, let us stop for a while and ponder upon this verse. Now the word of the Lord came unto Jonah, the son of Amittai. God was so specific. He wanted to talk with Jonah, the son of Amittai. Therefore, friends, when God calls, he is so specific. When God calls each one of us, he is so specific. When God calls, he knows who you are. When God calls, He knows your details. When God calls, He knows what you're capable of. If God calls you now, what would be your response to Him? When God calls you now, this morning, what would be your answer to Him? Let us go to verse 2. Arise, go to Nineveh, that great city, and cried out against it, for their wickedness has come up before me. Brethren, these words arise and go, these words are the command or imperative. This is the command that Jonah must follow. Jonah supposed to follow this command to go to Nineveh, that great city. But what happened? What happened to Jonah? Let's go to verse 3. But Jonah rose up and flee to Tarshish from the presence of the Lord. So what happened? He went down to Joppa, found a ship which was going to Tarshish, and paid the fare and went down into it to go with them to Tarshish from the presence of the Lord. This is the act of unfaithfulness coming from Jonah. He chose not to follow God's command, and this is where it starts. Friends, this is the map. From Joppa going to Tarshish, and from Joppa going to Nineveh. Okay? Let us go deeper to the explanation. When Jonah went to Joppa, Joppa was 30 miles northwest of Jerusalem. It was the only natural harbor on Israel's southern Mediterranean coast. It would have taken 2 or 3 days to go 60 miles from his hometown in Gath Hepher to Joppa. And Tarshish is 20 or 2,000 miles away. Therefore, Jonah knew that when he ran away from God's presence, it was very far. He knew that it took 2 to 3 days. It took for 2,000 miles away. Therefore, friends, church members and students, Jonah's determination to run away from the Lord was no snap decision. When he decided to run away from the Lord, it was no snap decision. Therefore, it was his plans. He has planned it. Jonah has planned it to run away from God's presence. Therefore, be careful with your plans. Make sure when you make plans, you go to the Lord first. You consult Jesus about it. Do not just make plans and then force Jesus to answer the plans that we have made in life. Friends, because sometimes the plans that we have in life can bring us away from the Lord. We must be careful with the plans that we have in life. Let us go to verse 4. And the Lord hurled a great wind on the sea, and there was a great storm on the sea, so that the ship was about to break up. Take note of this. If something happens in your life, think, perhaps you run away from the presence of the Lord. Let me say this again. If something happens in your life, think, perhaps you run away from the presence of the Lord. Sometimes, or probably most of the time, what happens in our life, it is not because of God, but it is because what we have done based on our decision. Sometimes, if something happens in our life, we go to the Lord and complain to the Lord on what has happened. Sometimes even we question the Lord if he is real or not because of what has happened in our lives. But friends, before you go to the Lord, before you doubt him, before you question him, before you try to doubt him, you ask first whether you run away from the presence of the Lord or not. Friends, if something happens in your life, think perhaps you run away from the presence of the Lord. Therefore, the point number one is, when you run away from the Lord, something will happen in your life. When you are not faithful to the Lord, something will happen in your life. Let us go to verse 5. Then the sailors became afraid, and every man cried out to his God as they threw the cargo which was on the ship into the sea to lighten it for them. But Jonah had gone below into the hold of the ship, lain down and fallen sound. The expression of Jonah gone below of the ship, there is any possibility the reason Jonah was gone below of the ship because he was hoping to remain unnoticed, hoping that no one would remind him of his sinful obedience. Jonah the Jew, instead of praying to the Lord for help, he was gone below of the ship to hide because of the sinfulness, because of the wrong action that he had done during that time. See, you can see this. This is the result of Jonah's action of being unfaithful. Sometimes we like to do just like what Jonah did. Because of our action, because we are not faithful to the Lord, because we are going away from the presence of the Lord, we would like to hide ourselves because of our actions. Friends, remember this. Sin is like a heavy cargo. Sin is like a heavy cargo. We need to throw it away. Do not bring it all the time. I don't know what kind of sins that you are having right now, dear friends, sir or ma'am. I do not know that. But let me tell you, sin is like a heavy cargo. The more you carry it, the more you feel tired. The more you carry it, the more it becomes heavy. Therefore, you need to throw it away. Do not stay faithful with your sin. Do not love the sins that you have in life. You need to throw it away. Because whether you like it or not, sin is still sin. You need to throw it away. Therefore, the point number two, when you run away from the Lord, you will pay something expensive in your life. What was the point number one? When you run away from the Lord, something happen will in your life. Something will happen in your life. The point number two, remember this. When you run away from the Lord, you will pay something expensive in your life. There will always be consequences when you go away from God's presence. There will always be consequences. Put this in your mind, sir, ma'am, friends, students. If you go away from God's presence, this is the price that you need to pay when you are not faithful to the Lord. Friends, perhaps you will ask me, sir, What do you mean by something expensive? Friends, I don't want to know that. I do not know the answer because I do not want to know that. But one thing that I know, if we run away from the Lord, if we are not faithful to the Lord, there is something expensive that you need to have in your life. Something expensive that you need to pay in your life. Be careful. Be careful. Let us go to verse 8. Then they say to him, "Tell us now, whose account has this calamity has struck us? What is your occupation? And when do you come from? Where do you come from? What is your country? And from what people are you?" And Jonah responded to them, "I am a Hebrew, and I fear the Lord, God of heaven, who made the sea and the dry land." Let's go to verse 10. Then the man became extremely frightened, and they say to him, "How could you do this?" For the man knew he was fleeing from the presence of the Lord because he had told them. Do you see something here, friends? There is something nice from verse 9 and verse 10. There is something that you need to know, that you need to dig something. Okay? There is something contrary from verses 9 and 10. If you have a Bible with you, kindly open it. Let us study together. There is a contrary idea from verse 9 and verse 10. In verse 9, Jonah said, "I fear the Lord, God of heaven, who made the sea and the dry land." In verse 10, instead of the people becoming very happy because there was a man who knew God, who feared the Lord, instead of they became assured because there was this guy, then the reaction was in verse 10, then the man became extremely frightened. For the man knew that Jonah was fleeing away from the presence of the Lord. Therefore, Jonah's action was contradicted with what he said. Words must go along with our actions. Oftentimes, we like to say, "Oh, I'm a Seventh-day Adventist. Oh, I'm coming from a UPA. I'm coming from Western Mindanao Academy. I'm coming from Baguio Academy. I'm coming from MAC High School student. I'm coming from IS Academy. I'm coming from different academy. Oh, I'm the son of a pastor. Oh, I'm a teacher. Oh, I'm a preacher. Oh, I'm a missionary. Oh, I'm a Seventh-day Adventist." But sometimes our actions are not going along with what we said. "Oh, I'm a faithful member of Seventh-day Adventist Church. Oh, I serve the church. Oh, I am a Christian." But sometimes our words do not go along with our actions. If, friends, make sure your words will say about who you are. Sometimes we like to cover our sinfulness with our flowery words. What about you, to those who are here with us this Sabbath? Are you this kind of people who like to appear holy, but in reality, you are not like that? Friends, it is not enough saying, "I fear the Lord," without doing what God has commanded you to do in your life. Most of the time, we put ourselves higher than the Lord. It seems we are the one who is commanding the Lord on what to do. We forget we are just the creatures. He is the creator. But sometimes we put ourselves as the one who created the Lord. We are the one who are commanding the Lord. Lord, I want this. Lord, I want that. Lord, answer my prayer. I want it right now. Instead of following, instead of doing what God has commanded us to do in our lives, but we just simply commanding Him. Friends, when we are faithful enough to the Lord, we would not have any excuse to not follow His command in our lives. Stop making excuses. When God says something, what we need to do is just to follow. Let's go to verse 11. So they say to Him, "What should we do to you that the sea may become calm for us?" For the sea was becoming increasingly stormy. In verse 12, He said to them, "Pick me up and throw into the sea. Then the sea will become calm for you. For I know that on account of me, this great storm has come up upon you." Jonah, the prophet. Jonah, that he said he knew and he feared the Lord. Jonah, during that time, did not just cause problem to himself, but also to the people around him. When Jonah ran away from the presence of the Lord, let me say this again to all of you this Sabbath, this morning, when Jonah ran away from the presence of the Lord, he did not just cause problem to himself, but also to the people around him. Do you know, sir and ma'am, friends, do you know the saddest thing in life? When you become a curse in somebody's life instead of blessing. Let me say this again. Do you know the saddest thing in life? When you become a curse in somebody's life instead of blessing. What kind of person are you, students? What kind of person are you, ma'am or sir? What kind of person are you, parents? What kind of person are we? Are we that kind of person who just simply enter somebody's life and brings misery? Or we are that kind of individuals who enter somebody's life to bring blessings and happiness? Are we that kind of individuals who always bring sadness, problems in somebody's life? Or when people look at us, they say, "I really like this kind of person because when he says something, I see God in him." But Jonah, the prophet again, he caused a big problem to the people around him. Jonah, the prophet, became a curse instead of blessing. Ouch. Ouch. Jonah the prophet became a curse instead of blessings. Friends, be the blessings to the people around you, but not curse. Let me repeat this again. Be the blessings to the people around you, but not curse. Friends, the question remains, what kind of person are you? What kind of person are you? What was the point number one again? The point number one, when you run away from the Lord, something will happen in your life. The point number two, when you run away from the Lord, you will pay something expensive in your life. The point number three, when you run away from the Lord, you will not just cause problems in your life, but also to others. If something happens in your life, think perhaps you run away from the presence of the Lord. Let us go to verse 15. So they picked up Jonah. They threw Jonah into the sea, and the sea stopped its raging. We jump to verse 17. And the Lord appointed a great fish to swallow Jonah. And Jonah was in the stomach of the fish 3 days and three nights. This is the pattern of Jonah chapter 1. You can take note of this. You can write this down. Okay. In verse 2, we can see Jonah. God commanded Jonah to go to Nineveh. In verse 3, we can see Jonah. In verse 3, Jonah went down to Joppa. In verse 3 also, we can see also, Jonah went down into the ship and went to Tarshish. In verse 5, Jonah again went down again below in the hold of the ship, let down and fallen sound asleep. In verse 15, Jonah was thrown into the sea. In verse 17, Jonah was swallowed by a big fish. Look at, see the pattern now. Jonah went down. Jonah went down to Joppa. And Jonah went again to Tarshish. And he went down again to the part of the ship. And he fallen asleep. And he was thrown down into the sea. And then the big fish swallowed Jonah and brought Jonah down to the part of the ship. To the part of the sea. Therefore, I would like to make last point. How to make last point for this Sabbath? When you run away from the Lord, your life will be down, down, and down. When you are not faithful to the Lord, your life will be down, down, and down. When you run away from the presence of the Lord, your life will be down, down, and down. Friends, it is so dangerous when you are not faithful and decided to run away from God's presence. Do not wait until we are already down there and we decided to run, not to run anymore from him. Do not wait until you are down there and you're starting to cry out to the Lord. Do not wait until you are down there and then you're starting to cry out for help from the Lord. Do not wait. Do not wait until you are down there. Start from wherever you are right now. But there is something beautiful. There is something beautiful we can see from the book of Jonah chapter 1. Even though you are down there, there is something beautiful. God is there to rescue you and bring you into a right place, just like what he did to Jonah. Friends, never ever try yourself to lie to God. He knows. Never ever try yourself to run away from the Lord. People will know. You can just pretend that you are not running away from the Lord. You can say to others, no, I'm fine. I'm okay. I'm like this. I'm like that. But people around you, people who are in now beside you, can feel it and know whether you are running away from the Lord or not. Friends, no matter how far you go, no matter how well you think you can hide, people will always realize that you go away from the Lord. No matter how far you go, no matter how well you think you can hide, people will always realize that you go away from the Lord. But friends, there is assurance here. when Jonah refused to obey him and tried to run away from him, God prepared a storm to stop him. Sometimes the storm that we have in life, sometimes it is not always to bring us down, but it will tell us that we need to stop running from the Lord. When Jonah was sorry, God prepared a great fish to swallow Jonah. When Jonah was down there, God picked Jonah up and brought him to the right place. Friends, mom and sir, when God says to go to Nineveh, no need for further explanation, need to arise and go. Let me tell you this, friends, mom and sir, parents who are joining with us this morning, if God wants you to be there, God will bring you there. If God wants you to be there, you will be there no matter what happens in your life. Even though Jonah tried to go to Tarshish because God wanted Jonah to be in Nineveh, no matter how far he went, no matter how well he thought he could hide from the Lord, when God wanted Jonah to go to Nineveh, he brought Jonah to Nineveh. Therefore, when God wants you to be in one place, you will be there. No need for further explanations. What we need to do is to arise and go. Friends, he is an I don't care how far you have run, just come home kind of God. The theme for this Sabbath for our youth for this is God's glory. God, glory, greatness, and growth. Friends, you will not go and you will not grow if you are running away from the presence of the Lord. You cannot feel his greatness if you are not faithful to the Lord. You cannot see his glory if you are not faithful to the Lord. Friends, perhaps you are now, or you think you want to run. Stop. Stop wherever you are. Perhaps some of you are about to run. Stop. Stop. Stop wherever you are. Perhaps you just started to run. Stop for a while. Perhaps you've gone too far, because you've been running for a long time. Stop where you are. Stop wherever you are. God is willing to have you back. No matter how far you've gone away from him, God is still willing to take you back. God is still willing to take you back. Perhaps some students from Palawan Adventist School and are running away from him. Stop wherever you are. What about the students coming from the Lipa Adventist Academy? Are you now running away from him? What about from the Baguio Seventh-day Adventist School? What about you? Are you now running away? What about the students coming from the Central Philippines Adventist College Academy? Are you now running away from the Lord? If you are students, if you are students or teachers or even sir or mom or parents, stop wherever you are. God is willing to have you back because he is an I don't care how far you have run, just come home kind of God. Friends, coming from Conception's Adventist Academy, and to all of us who are here right now this morning, no more excuses. I hope you will no longer make excuses to not trust him, to not pray, to stop praying and to stop saying thank you from the Lord. Remember the 4G, God, glory, greatness, and growth. You will never experience this if you go away from God's presence. You will never experience this four when you put excuses to run away from His presence. Friends, put away your excuses because Jesus loves you. He loves you because of who you are. He is willing to have you back. He's willing to have you back. Friends, it is time to reconnect ourselves with the Lord. Stop wherever you are. Stop wherever you are. God is willing to have you back. Jonah, from the story of Jonah, we can learn something. Yes, yes, you can run from the presence of the Lord, but you can never hide from His presence. And friends, do not make any decision. Never make any decision. Do not even think to run away from the Lord, because you'll pay something expensive, your life. Last, for all of us this Sabbath, last, when you can be faithful to the Lord, why choose not to be faithful? Happy Sabbath. May God bless us all.
At this point, I would like to present to you the Certificate of Appreciation to our guest speaker. I will read the citation. Adventist University of the Philippines Academy Certificate of Appreciation is presented to Jonathan Melvin Sagala for sharing an inspirational message as guest speaker during the Adventist Academy's Sabbath Fellowship Divine Worship, hosted by AUP Academy SG, with the theme Youth 4G, God, Glory, Greatness, Growth, given this ninth day of April 2022 at the Adventist University of the Philippines Academy, Putincahoy, Silang, Cavite, via Zoom. Signed, Daniel Joy Arit, SG President, Isa M. Ramirez, and Gerard M. Asi, SG Advisors, and Ardelma V. Sarmiento, AUP Academy Principal.
Praise the Lord, let the earth hear His voice.
Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this beautiful program where we are coming from different schools just to worship and praise your name. Thank you, Lord, for allowing us to worship you though we are far away from one another. And thank you, Almighty Father, for the beautiful message that we have just learned. Help us, Almighty Father, wherever we go, so we can always be a blessing, but not a curse to the people around us. Help us, Almighty Father, not to run away from you. Help us, Almighty Father, to stay faithful to you until the end of our lives. Lord, I would like to pray for the students that are coming from different schools. May you bless them, Almighty Father, as they study and finishing their formal education. May you give them knowledge from above so they can finish and many people will be blessed by their presence. Lord, we also pray for the teachers. You've called them and chosen them to work in different institutions. Lord, help them. Give them wisdom and knowledge from above. So when they stand, when they teach, when they pray for the students, many people will be blessed by their presence because you are with them. And many people also can see Jesus through these teachers, Almighty Father. We also to pray for the parents for entrusting their children to study in your institution. May you bless all the business and all the works that they are doing. May it may be fruitful. And then these parents can bless many people because you have blessed them in many ways. Lord, help us to stay faithful always. Help us not to run away from you. Help us so we can always be coming a blessing, but not curse to the people around us. Thank you, Lord, for this opportunity. In his name we pray. Amen.
This is the truth.